Hello and welcome to our meditation this Sunday, the second meditation for the month of July. As we gather this day, I invite you to share with me the call to worship. Let us share together. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Please, Lord, please give us success. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord is God shining upon us. Bring forth the sacrifice and put it on the altar. You are my God, and I will praise you. You are my God, and I will exalt you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His faithful love endures from ever. Indeed, his love endures forever. Amen. From Psalm 118. As we gather today in Jesus' name, I invite you to share the greeting shared with people that Jesus met in his ministry and his life's journey. It is a single Hebrew word that has multiple meanings. It means welcome. I'm glad you're here. Hello, how are you? May you have well-being and on your journey safety, and may you have peace of body, mind, and spirit. And that simple word is shalom. And I invite you now to share with those with you gathered this day to share that word, shalom in Christ, shalom. And as we gather this day, we again light this memorial candle to remind us of all those who are suffering from the COVID virus, those who have passed away from this virus, and those who mourn their loss, to remember our nation in crisis, to remember our nation as it strives for racial equality, that black lives do indeed matter, and that we care for one another in hope, in help, and in healing. Remember, as John Gospel says, the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness cannot put it out. Indeed, the light of God is shining always for us, and the darkness cannot put it out. And I invite you now to share with me our prayer preparation for this day. Let us pray. Praise him, Jesus, blessed Savior, is worthy to be praised. Dear Heavenly Father, we come today with humble hearts and spirit. We acknowledge that you are our Father and shield us with your blessings and love. The earth is the Lord's and everything in it. Continue to watch over us. Continue to guide us through the narrow path. Continue to shine your light for all to see. Continue to guide the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. We give you the glory, the honor, and the praise forever. This is our prayer in the name of Jesus. Amen.
One, two, three.
I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. Praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light, I saw the light. No more darkness, no more night. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in. Back to side.
As we gather this Sunday, I share this lesson from Luke's Gospel. Jesus is being crucified. He is on the cross with two other thieves. One of the thieves rebukes him, and the other asks him for mercy and care and compassion. This is one of the last seven words of Jesus as a response to that thief. The first voice is the thief's voice. The second voice is Jesus' voice. It's from Luke Gospel, chapter 23, verses 42 and 43. Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." He replied, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise." May God add blessings to the reading of this word and bring blessing to those who hear the word and live this word. Amen. Brothers and sisters in Christ, we live in very, very troubled times right now. This is the worst pandemic in this nation in over 100 years. This is, again, a concern for racial equality, which we've not seen in probably almost a half century. It is a time of concern, care, and deep confusion. And many are afraid and uncomfortable by the journey that we're now passing through. And one of the things that concerns me is that many religious leaders do not take this pandemic seriously. One minister in a church, I believe in Florida, said, "If it's God's will I have the COVID virus, it is God's will." I will say that is utterly untrue. That is not God's love for his creation or for us as individuals who are created in his image. And that's why I chose this simple passage from Luke's Gospel. The seven last words of Jesus are the words he uttered on the cross at his crucifixion. They're not all found in one place. They're spread through the four Gospels. This particular piece is from Luke's Gospel. He's being crucified by the Roman government and being tried and condemned by the Jewish religious elite. On the cross, one of the thieves says, "If you're the Son of God, get us down," and mocks him. The second one says these words, "Jesus, remember me when you come into the kingdom, your kingdom." That's a unique statement. This is the only place in the four Gospels where someone just calls Jesus by his first name. Not rabbi, teacher, lord, or master, or Jesus, Son of God, but just Jesus as a very personal and intimate relationship with him. That when we call on Jesus, we have that intimate relationship with him. And we are calling upon him, all of us, who have faith in the good news. Jesus, help us when you come into your kingdom. And again, that person on the cross is saying, when you arrive in your kingdom, your heavenly place, let your hand reach out and take me there also. Jesus says in return to him, "Truly I tell you, today you will be in paradise with me." Today you will be in paradise. Not in some future time, but now. And Jesus says those words to us this day in this time of crisis and concern, confusion and loss. Today you are with me in paradise, where there is help, where there is hope, where there is healing. Not at some future time, but this moment, that we can call upon our Lord, our Savior, and Christ's hand reaches out to us to hold us as we pass through this time of fear, to put our, his arm around us, to give us comfort and hope and healing, saying, I am with you. That you can overcome the illness, you will overcome the prejudiced, and we're here to be, I'm here to be with you and for you. And hopefully today all of us can be here with Jesus, our hands out to welcome, our arms stretched to embrace, that today we can be in paradise. Maybe not this moment, but we can pass through this moment and go beyond that. And I invite you to take that comfort and that hope. God does not want us to see us coming down with a virus. That's evil. That's, if you will, sin. That's not the plan of God. It's in the world. There is a lower power that does tempt us and coerce us. It's not the higher power that's found in Christ, who is our guide, our friend, and our Savior. So I invite you to remember these words this day, as you pass through this day, and each and every day, a day at a time. Truly, Jesus said, I tell you, today you are with me in paradise, in the place of peace, in the place of hope, in the place of healing. God bless and keep each and every one of you this day. This I say in Christ's name. Amen. As we gather for prayer this day, I ask that you remember in your prayers those who are suffering from the virus, illness, those who are suffering and experience prejudice and anger and hatred, to pray for the leadership of our government and governments in this country, that they have the wisdom of God, the love of God within them to guide us through this time of concern, to pray for our church family, to pray for our neighbors and friends, to pray for those whom we may even disagree with, that God's presence will be with each of us and all of us to bring about a healing, that indeed this day we can be in paradise of faith, hope, and love. Let us pray. Gracious God, our Creator, who from the earth of the ground formed us and created us as the Adam, the first human, a living being, whose breath entered into that Adam and gave it life. Your breath has come into us, we who are created in your image, with the breath of life. We ask again each day for that breath. And that breath comes to us, as Jesus says, as the Holy Spirit, to come within us, to help us, to heal us, to give us hope and strength, to face each day, O God, with courage. Be our presence, be our guide. Be with those who are suffering and are ill. Be with those who mourn. Be with those who feel prejudice and hatred towards them, not for what they are, but for who they are. Pray for them, not because of their inner self, but outer self, that they may experience the hope and healing and help. We pray this day for our congregation, that we all be well and have hope. We pray for friends and neighbors, that the presence of God may be with them to guide them. And we pray especially for the leadership of this nation, that your wisdom, your presence, and indeed your shalom be with them, as they lead us to a day of recovery and healing. Hear our prayers, O God, this day. This we ask in Christ's name. Amen.
Let the words of my mouth.
I invite you to share with me the prayer Jesus taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I wish each of you well this coming week. I wish you well this day, each and every day. And to know that in faith we are all in paradise at this moment. God bless you and keep you. And may you share that good news with one another. This I ask in Christ's name. And as we close this day, I invite you to share the benediction with me. Let us share that benediction. Jesus, our blessed Savior, is worthy to be praised. Go in peace. Amen. God bless you and keep you. Amen.